Welcome back to the channel. As a former master's PhD student in psychology and cognitive science, one of the things that I enjoy doing is analyzing popular culture in terms of academic psychology and cognitive science. One of the most popular videos that I've done thus far was on Breaking Bad. Specifically, I looked at how two well-studied cognitive biases, anchoring and the fundamental attribution error, played out in the minds of viewers as they interpreted the behavior of Walter White. I will link this video here, and you can check it out. In today's video, I'm going to talk about what we can learn from iTunes Music Visualizer. As an aside, if there are any other cool psychological effects that you would like to see demonstrated using pop culture, let me know and in the comment section, and I may just make a video on that. Anyhow, in order to experience the psychological phenomena I'll be discussing in this video, you'll really need to watch and listen attentively.
I think there's been a rape up there! I got his attention. Get their attention.
In addition to the typical background music I put in my videos, throughout this video, you will see the iTunes Music Visualizer. I'm going to briefly turn off the music and ask you to pay attention to the visualizer. Try to notice as much as you can about what is happening. Notice how at any given moment you see movement happening at multiple tempos or rates. You will see some aspects of what you are seeing moving or changing at a fast rate, others at a medium rate, and others at a slow rate. You may see a slowly growing ball, a rapidly flickering light, and those balls may be moving around the screen at a medium pace, for example. You will see some aspects of the screen presenting as relatively intense, perhaps due to fast movement or bright colors or rapid growth. And you'll see other aspects of the screen coming off as low intensity, you know, for example, through slower movement, muted or soft colors, or softer rate of color changing. At any given moment, then, you're going to be seeing things of varying levels of speed and intensity. The song that you're now listening to is the instrumental version of Midnight City by M83. While the speed and intensity of this song varies, overall, the song is pretty moderate in terms of both. I'm going to set the video back to the beginning. This time, watch and listen. Okay, now let's change it up. The next thing I'm going to play is a collaboration featuring Busta Rhymes and Twista, two of the fastest rappers of all time. Once again, I'm going to start the video back from the beginning so that we're comparing apples to apples. Gonna be some energy, we got the remedy. I'm in the vicinity of a nigga that can spit it with me. Fill the fire whenever we act up. Everybody else is a compiler with the artillery. So forget about it when you hear about it, cause it's too fast when the past over time to bust them. Hit a victim in the middle of the body with a bullet and a rhythm, every murdering is structure. Every time I hit you, nigga, with another chamber, then I'm black and I'll be sounding like a nigga full of anger. Now I'm back to beat you in the head, I bring another banger. When my niggas with everything we do, we got the ranger. You don't really, really wanna see the way you're coming in. I give it to you, get it, born until a nigga numb. Do what I wanna do until I make another nigga drop. I'm gonna do it, homie, I'm the one. Go ahead, pick it up and carry it to where you wanna carry it to, we'll do whatever you wanna do. Show the competition how we gonna do. Now let's go to the other extreme. My Immortal, a slow song by Evanescence. And apples to apples, we're going to go right back to the beginning again.
I'm so tired of being here, suppressed by all my childish fears. And if you have to leave, I wish that you would just leave. Your presence still lingers here, and it won't leave me alone. These wounds won't seem to heal. This pain is just too real. There's just too much that time cannot erase. When you cried, I'd...
All right, one last song. this time, let's up the speed and the intensity. Here's a clip from Dig by Mudvayne. If you're experiencing all of this the way that I have, you're probably noticing that while the video doesn't always match up with the sound, it frequently does. But how could that be? It's the exact same video with four songs of greatly different tempos and intensity. The answer to the question is how our brains and minds solve what cognitive scientists, including psychologists, call the binding problem. The idea here is that humans have multiple senses. Each provides information to the brain about what's happening. But these are all separate types of input. The binding problem refers to the question of how our brains manage to integrate or bind these different sensory inputs. Our brains are actually quite good at this. Just consider how quickly and easily you notice and get distracted when the audio and visual components of a video that you are watching are off by even a fraction of a second. And consider any time that you have watched a dubbed video. Few of us consider ourselves to be lip readers, but we are very good at recognizing when the movements of a mouth and the sound coming out of it do not match. Or consider how much easier it is to understand what someone is saying when they are not wearing a COVID mask. It's not just the muffling factor. We really do read each other's lips. Going back to the songs in the visualizer, what seems to be happening is that the aspects of the screen that our brains are foregrounding or overnoticing are those whose tempo or intensity best match what is being heard. So for example, our minds will foreground slow-moving aspects of the screen during slow music, while simultaneously backgrounding the faster-moving aspects of the screen. We overnotice what matches and undernotices what doesn't, almost like a sort of perceptual confirmation bias. It's the exact opposite for faster songs. The end result is that it can appear that the visualizer has been made to match the music. It clearly hasn't, though, as we've just demonstrated. Sometimes, though, nothing on the screen will match the tempo or intensity of the song. These are the times when you do not perceive there to be any significant relationship between what you're seeing and what you're hearing. And it makes sense that our brains work like this. After all, so far as we can tell, in the natural world, there usually are close correspondences between what we see and what we hear. So, for example, a hard slap will coincide with a louder slapping sound than a soft slap. Further, the sound of the slap should be heard at the moment when the slap is landed.
How can you slap?
The fact that for a long time humans mistook lightning and thunder to be separate events is consistent with this. Sometimes our minds will go even further than this, however. Instead of just over-noticing something from one sense that matches something from another, sometimes our minds will flat-out hallucinate things in an apparent attempt to harmonize the input from different senses. To give just one example of this, I'm going to cite what has been called the McGurk effect, after one of its discoverers. In the late 70s, McGurk and his colleague McDonald, a pair of psycholinguists, wanted to see what would happen if they created a mismatch between what was seen and what was heard linguistically. What they did was show participants video of a person talking or making sounds. Their trick was that they would dub in a different phoneme or speech sound from what the person in the video actually said. So the result from this was that participants reported having heard neither the phoneme that was played auditorily to them, nor the phoneme that was mouthed to them by the person in the video, but rather they heard some intermediate phoneme, as it was called by the authors.
Have a look at this. Ba, what do you hear?
Ba, ba, ba. Ba, ba, ba.
But look what happens when we change the picture.
Ba, ba, ba. Ba, ba, ba. Ba.
And yet, the sound hasn't changed. In every clip, you are only ever hearing bar with a B.
Bar, bar.
My guess is, after watching that, you just had a similar effect. So in an apparent attempt to harmonize what was seen with what was heard into one coherent, unified perception, the mind appears to be splitting the difference and just manufacturing something that never happened. All right, so that does it for this one. As I said at the top, if there are any other interesting psychological phenomena that you would like to see demonstrated using pop culture, leave a comment. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next video.